起身啊！
好，
起身。冇嘢揸住啊！
中間啊，唔該。
OK。好，呢邊。OK。
好啦，我諗大家差唔多啦，咁就歡迎大家出席今日嘅記者會啦。咁今日我哋出席嘅官員咧就有政制及內地事務局局長聶德權，咁喺佢嘅左手邊咧就係副秘書長李佩斯，咁喺佢右手邊咧就係首席助理秘書長林偉琪嘅。咁首先，局長咧就會同大家會有一個開場嘅發言，咁之後就會係簡單咁樣介紹國歌條例草案裏邊嘅內容，咁之後咧就係提問時間。咁喺提名嘅時候咧，請大家就先舉手啦。咁跟住就講大家嘅姓名同埋即係代表機構嘅名字。咁而家就將時間交俾局長先。
好，多謝各位傳媒朋友。今日咧就呢個記者會咧就係想同大家介紹一下咧有關呢個國歌條例草案嘅嚇。第十二屆全國人民代表大會常務委員會咧就喺2017年11月4日就通過咗決定，就將中華人民共和國國歌法列入基本法附件三。咁根據基本法附件根據基本法嘅第十八條嘅規定咧，凡係列喺基本法附件三嘅全國性法律咧，就由香港特別行政區喺當地公布或者係立法實施。因此咧，香港特區政府係有憲制責任咧喺本地實施國歌法嘅。行政長官會同行政會議咧就喺昨日嘅會議上咧就係通過向立法會提交國歌條例草案。透過本地立法的形式在香港實施國歌法，考慮到香港的普通法法律制度和香港的實際情況，我們用本地立法的形式在香港特區實施全國性的國歌法，這個做法是充分體現一國兩制的精神。國歌法一共有16條的條文，除了國歌法的第9、第14和第16條以外，其餘13條的條文呢已經是適當地納入我們本地的條例草案，稍後我會再跟大家解釋一下。條例草案的立法原則呢就是很清晰的，一呢是必須維持國家國歌法的立法目的和原意，明確維護國歌的尊嚴，規範國歌的奏唱、播放和使用，同時呢也要充分兼顧到香港的普通法法律制度同埋香港嘅實際情況。條例草案咧主要有兩個重點嚇。第一咧就係呢個條例草案咧係指明咧國歌係國家嘅象徵同埋標誌。咁啊透過指引性嘅條文咧，讓市民係尊重國歌。第二咧就係就一啲公開同埋故意侮辱國歌嘅行為咧，係訂立刑罰。總體而言咧，條例草案嘅主要精神咧就係尊重。呢種嘅尊重精神咧，其實係自然嘅，係容易理解嘅，同埋咧係容易做得到嘅。因此咧，國歌條例對於市民大眾嘅日常生活咧係唔會有影響嘅。不過咧，就住一啲意圖侮辱國歌、公開同埋故意作出侮辱國歌行為嘅人士咧，條例草案咧係需要列出罰則，對呢一類嘅行為咧係起阻嚇嘅作用。喺草擬條例草案嘅過程當中咧，我哋細心聆聽社會各界嘅意見，喺舊年三月我哋就立法嘅建議嗰個嘅框架內容咧，係諮詢咗立法會政制事務委員會，並且喺舊年嘅4月同埋5月咧，分別出席咗2場咧由委員會舉辦嘅公聽會，聽取市民同埋團體嘅意見。此外咧，我哋亦都同唔同嘅政黨團體嘅代表，包括教育界啊、演藝文化界啊、法律界嘅代表。同埋學者等咧，係進行過溝通同埋討論嘅。咁啊，我哋會喺呢個月嘅23日將條例草案咧係提交立法會首讀，並會咧喺將會成立嘅法案委員會度咧啊，同議員討論，聽取佢哋咧對條例草案條文嘅意見嚇。跟住落嚟，我用英文咧講一講嗰個開場發言嚇。The Standing Committee of the 12th National People's Congress adopted on the 4th of November 2017 the decision to add the law of the People's Republic of China on National Anthem Law to Annex 3 to the Basic Law. According to Article 18 of the Basic Law, the national laws listed in Annex 3 to the Basic Law shall be applied locally by way of promulgation or legislation by the Hong Kong Special Administrative Region. It is thus the constitutional responsibility of the Hong Kong SAR government to implement the national anthem law locally. The Chief Executive in Council at his meeting yesterday agreed that the National Anthem Bill should be introduced into the Legislative Council to implement the National Anthem Law in Hong Kong by local legislation. Having regard to the common law system practiced in Hong Kong, as well as the actual circumstances in Hong Kong, the National Anthem Law in the Hong Kong SAR will be implemented by local legislation. This approach fully demonstrates the spirit of the One Country, Two Systems principle. The National Anthem Law consists of 16 clauses. Apart from Articles 9, 14, and 16, all the rest of 13 clauses have been suitably reflected in the National Anthem Bill of the Hong Kong SAR. I will further elaborate on this later. The legislative principle of the National Anthem Bill is to fully reflect the purpose and intent of the National Anthem Law, which is to preserve the dignity of the National Anthem and promote respect for the National Anthem, and at the same time to give due regard to the common law system practiced in Hong Kong, as well as the actual circumstances in Hong Kong. The crux of the National Anthem Bill is two-pronged. A, to state that the National Anthem is the symbol and sign of the People's Republic of China, and to lead people to respect the National Anthem by directional provisions. B, to introduce penalties for people who publicly and intentionally insult the National Anthem. Overall speaking, the main spirit of the National Anthem Bill is respect, a behavior which is natural, easily understood, and not hard to display. As such, the bill will not affect the daily life of the general public. Nonetheless, for those with an intent to insult the National Anthem and publicly and intentionally perform acts to insult the National Anthem, there is a need to introduce punitive provisions in the bill with a view to deterring such behaviors. In the course of drafting the bill, we have listened carefully to the views of the various sectors of the community. We consulted the Legislative Council panel on constitutional affairs in March last year and attended two public hearings in April and May respectively, during which individuals and organizations were invited to give their views. Besides, we also exchanged views and conducted discussions with different political parties, sector representatives, including the education sector, the performing arts and culture sector, as well as representatives and academics of the legal sector. We will submit the bill to the Legislative Council for first reading on the 23rd of this month. We will listen to the views of members of the Legislative Council during the discussions and deliberations at the Bills Committee to be set up later. 跟住落嚟咧，我或者我重點介紹一下咧，有關嗰、那個條例草案裏邊咧嗰個嘅內容，咁就可以方便大家稍後咧就一啲關注嘅範圍咧可以再去提問嘅嚇。第一咧就係、呢個嘅條例草案本身咧就係、是我哋係將全國性嘅國歌法例咧係進行一個本地立法工作，所以我哋係考慮咗香港嘅本身嗰個普通法嘅法律制度同埋香港嘅實際情況。咁亦都係咧，係用翻咧我哋自己本身喺草擬本地法例嘅時候咧，嗰、那個嘅草擬嘅一個嘅模式。咁所以大家睇見咧，呢個嘅條文本身咧係同全國性嘅法律咧喺個結構上咧，亦都係不盡相同。咁喺嗰個嘅條例草案裏邊咧，主要咧係分開有一個嘅弁言啦 （preamble）， 有六個部分，同埋咧係三個附表。咁喺弁言嗰部分咧，其實就體現咗國歌法嚇，即係全國性法律咧嘅第一、第三同埋第五條嘅內容。它主要是說明了條例草案的背景，以助了解這條條例草案。條例草案的第一步是一個導言，列出了條例草案的簡稱、釋義。我們也特別就着奏唱國歌作出一個定義，以清晰表達去涵蓋的範圍。接下來就是第二、第三和第四步，這三個部分是草案的核心的部分。第二部分是講緊奏唱國歌的嗰、那個嘅標準禮儀同埋場合，包括咧就係呢啲咧係一啲嘅指引性條文嚇，係冇帶罰則嘅。 咁啊，裏邊譬如話喺嗰個相關禮儀上邊嘅要求咧，係講緊咧就係話喺參與或者出席緊一個奏唱國歌場合嘅人士咧，咁咧就係應該咧係有相關嘅嗰啲嘅禮儀嚇。咁呢個係一個指引性嘅條文啦，呢個係不帶罰則啦，呢個亦都係咧係主要係指於嗰啲係出席同埋參與緊喺一個奏唱國歌場合嘅人咧嗰個嘅應該所表現嘅行為。咁所以咧就喺過去我哋討論嘅時候咧，有啲提到話啊，即係電視機播緊國歌，或者話行過嘅時候嗰度電視又播開國歌，咁咧呢個會唔會受影響咧？咁呢個你唔係參與緊一個咧奏唱國歌嘅場合嚇，咁希望咧呢一個寫法咧係亦都能夠可以咧係比較清晰嘅。咁啊，另外咧就係喺條例草案裏邊嘅咧第五條咧第一款咧就列明咗咧就係話我哋透過一個附表嘅形式咧。係會列明一啲嘅場合本身咧係需要奏唱國歌嘅嚇，係需要奏唱國歌。咁呢啲嘅場合咧係亦都喺全國性法律裏邊咧，佢都有相關嘅呢啲嘅場合。我哋都考慮咗香港實際嘅情況，跟住之後咧喺我哋嘅附表三裏邊咧列出喺香港邊啲嘅場合咧係應該定為一個需要奏唱國歌嘅場合。咁呢個係包括咧就係我哋喺特區政府即係每年會主辦嘅，譬如七一啊、十一嘅一啲就升旗禮，或者係官方嘅活動，或者係一啲嘅紀念儀式，亦都係咧包括咧係一啲嘅宣誓儀式嚇。呢個宣誓儀式咧係包括行政長官、主要官員、行政會議成員、法官同埋咧立法會議員嘅宣誓儀式咧，都係一個應當奏唱國歌嘅場合。咁啊，同埋咧包括譬如任何嘅升國旗嘅儀式咧，都係一個奏唱國歌嘅場合。特區政府舉辦的重大體育賽事啊，同埋咧法律年度開啟典禮嚇，咁呢個本身而家現時咧，我知道咧都已經係一個奏唱國歌嘅安排啦。咁就第三部分咧係保護國歌嚇，保護國歌呢一個咧，主要嚟講咧就係咧係對於一啲不當使用國歌係列出清楚係邊啲情況之下咧係唔應該咧係使用國歌嘅。咁呢個咧就係包括咧就係一啲嘅商標、商業廣告。一啲嘅私人喪事活動，同埋咧喺公眾場所咧作為背景音樂咧，呢個係不當使用國歌嘅。咁所以咧喺個條例草案裏邊咧，其實係列明咗一啲場合嚇。頭先我所講嘅嗰啲場合咧係唔應該奏唱國歌嘅。另外喺附表三裏邊咧係會列出一啲場合咧，呢啲場合本身係應當係需要奏唱國歌嘅場合。咁其餘嘅嚇就喺好多活動上邊。需要去即係是否係奏唱國歌咧？咁呢個當然就係嗰個活動嘅有關安排嘅機構，佢哋咧能夠可以作出嘅一個決定。但如果有奏唱國歌嘅儀式嘅時候咧，咁出席同埋參與其中嘅人士咧，都應該有相關應當嘅一個嘅尊重嘅禮儀嚇。咁另外一個嘅保護國歌嘅條文咧，就係、是。一個咧係侮辱國歌等等咧違反法例嘅行為咧，係需要有一個罰則啊。咁呢個咧就喺個條例草案裏邊咧係都係列明咗嘅。咁喺呢一方面咧，就主要嚟講咧就係條例草案嗰邊咧係禁止任何人意圖侮辱國歌，係公開同埋故意係一篡改國歌歌詞或者曲譜，或者係二以歪曲或者貶損嘅方式奏唱國歌。或者三以任何方式侮辱國歌，咁呢一個咧係本身咧會係有一個嘅，即係係一個罪行嘅條文，會係有一個嘅刑罰。咁個刑罰咧嘅水平咧，我哋都係參照咗喺國旗同埋國徽嘅條例裏邊咧嗰個嘅罰則，就係最高罰款咧係50,000元，同埋咧係監禁3年嚇。咁同翻國旗國徽嘅條例咧嗰個罰則嘅水平咧係一樣嘅。為了確保合理發布侮辱國歌資料的行為，例如傳媒作出一個公允報導，即係 fair reporting 的時候，或者教師做教育用途的時候咧，佢哋可能會去發布了一些侮辱國歌的資料，為了清楚地確保咧，就呢一啲嘅行為本身咧係唔會構成刑責咧，所以在條例草案裏邊嘅第七條第五款咧係特別定明咧，任何人咧係除了意圖侮辱國歌。而發布侮辱國歌資料之外咧，係唔會因為發布相關嘅資料咧而犯罪嘅。咁希望能夠咁樣寫得出嚟咧，亦都大家可以能夠清楚知道咧，係即係喺呢啲咁嘅情況之下咧，係唔會構成咧一個嘅罪行嘅。咁就我哋亦都參考咗國旗同埋國徽條例啦， 侮辱國家的罪行咧係屬於一個簡易治罪簡易程序的罪行啊 ，summary offence。咁啊，一般嘅情況咧係需要喺罪行發生之後嘅六個月內咧係作出檢控嘅。但係咧就我哋亦都同翻執法部門嚇，同埋咧有關嘅政策局去討論嘅時候咧，亦都係留意到咧，由於警方咧預計咧觸犯呢個嘅侮辱國歌行為呢個罪行咧嘅個案咧，好大機會咧可能會牽涉到大量嘅人士或者網上嘅行為啦，所以咧所需要嘅調查同埋搜證嘅時間咧都會比較長。咁啊，為咗有效執法咧，因此條例草案係建議延長咧係提出檢控嘅時限，就由一般嘅六個月咧，就係延長到咧係警務處處長嚇發現或者知悉有關罪行之後一年內，或者係個罪行發生之後咧兩年內啊，以較早者咧係為準。咁咧，我相信呢一個咧都係喺有效執法同埋檢控時效方面咧係作出咗平衡嘅。第四部分咧係有關推廣國歌。推廣國歌嗰度咧，主要係有兩個主要嘅部分啦。第一個喺教育方面，教育咧就係將國歌咧係納入中小學嘅教育，同埋要求咧係第二方面咧就係要求本地嘅持牌電視同電台咧係播放國歌嘅條文。咁呢個咧都係反映翻喺全國性國歌法法律裏邊咧係有相關嘅要求嘅。咁喺教育嗰方面咧，我哋目前嘅處理咧就係喺個條例草案裏邊咧，我哋係列明係要求咧教育局局長。就將國歌納入小學教育同埋中學教育咧，係發出指示。涵蓋嘅範圍咧，包括所有嘅中小學，亦都包括國際學校。具體嘅教與學嘅課程內容咧，仍然按翻現行喺教育系統裏邊嘅機制咧嚟去處理。因為咁樣嘅做法咧，既係能夠反映到全國性嘅國歌法裏邊嘅呢一方面嘅要求，嗱另一方面咧，亦都係透過我哋現行喺教育系統裏邊相關嘅機制咧嚟去處理有關嘅情況。而事實上喺目前咧，喺中小學呢啲嘅課程裏邊咧，都係有教授國歌咧相關嘅要求同埋咧呢啲嘅課程喺度嘅。咁啊喺呢個嘅本地持牌電視或者電台播放國歌方面嘅安排咧，我哋主要都係用翻現行嗰個機制，就係咧係透過現時嘅發牌條件裏邊咧係要有要求咧，就係政府係可以咧喺特定嘅時段裏邊咧係播放呢個政府嘅宣傳聲帶或者短片，即係所謂嘅 API 啦。我哋都用翻呢個機制咧嚟去即係播呢個國歌。咁啊，所以呢個嘅做法咧就會係同我哋現行嗰個做法咧係唔會有啲乜嘢嘅額外新加到落去嘅要求。咁另外第五、第六部分咧就係一啲嘅補充條文啦。補充條文咧，第五部分嗰度咧，主要嘅做法咧，就係希望能夠講明喺香港內觸犯有關國歌嘅規定嘅罪行咧，係按照香港嘅法律處理。並且定明咧，如果國歌條例同全國性國歌法有不相符之處咧，國歌條例咧係需要解釋為國歌法嘅特別實施情況。咁呢一個嘅安排呢個做法咧，係同國旗同國徽條例裏邊咧都有相類似嘅條文嘅。咁另外第六部分就有啲相應嘅修訂啦。咁呢個因為咧就係喺我哋嘅商標條例同埋我哋嘅法例發布條例裏邊咧，都要需要有一啲嘅相應修訂，所謂叫 consequential amendments 就係咁樣。咁所以咧就以上咧就係嗰個嘅條例草案裏邊咧就重點嗰啲嘅內容。咁就翻個別大家關注嘅情況咧，就可以大家再去提問，好嘛？唔該曬。
好，唔該曬局長。咁而家就係發問時間。咁有問題嘅請大家舉手。白色衫呢位女士，
三位你好，我是香港另一記者李偉恩。關於呢個侮辱行為罪行嗰部分咧，你哋提到就係話，由於即係有可能涉及一批大批身份不明確嘅肇事者，所以就會延長呢個檢控嗰個時限。想問一下咧，其實即係點解會延長呢個檢控時限？係咪一個尋常嘅做法？同埋即係為咗呢個國歌法呢條條例係咪有足夠嘅特殊性去做咧？係咪都反映到其實當局其實好有決心係要拉到人呢？另外就係喺奏唱國歌嗰部分啦，亦都包括就係立法會宣誓嗰度都宣誓儀式都要奏唱國歌。咁想問一下就係奏唱國歌係咪都係即係包含喺宣誓儀式嘅一部分啦？若果係中途離場的話，會唔會就係構成一個 DQ 嘅理由咧？唔該。
好啊，多謝你嚇。兩個問題嚇，第一個咧就係有關嗰個檢控時限方面嘅。咁就當然我哋草擬任何一條法例嘅時候咧，都要考慮到咧就係嗰個即係是否能夠可以有效執行啦嗰個問題。咁所以咧喺亦都係所以係按照實際情況嘅。所以呢一個一般嘅做法咧就係個六個月啦。咁而家我哋嗰個建議咧就係將嗰個嘅檢控時限咧係即係延長嘅。 咁類似呢個做法咧，亦都唔係淨係呢一條條例裏邊嘅草案裏邊有嘅，喺現時我哋嘅其他法例裏邊咧，有一啲嘅法例咧都有相類似嘅一啲咁嘅條文安排嘅。咁所以呢個咧就唔係一啲即係全新嘅嘢嚟嘅。咁所以主要考慮咧都係就係喺嗰個要確保有一個有效嘅能夠落實到啦、執法得到啦，但係咧就嗰個檢控嘅時候當然唔可以係過於所需要嘅長啦。咁所以咧就喺兩者之中咧係作平衡咧，就提出呢一方面嗰個建議嘅。第二個問題咧就係有關嗰個嘅即係喺宣誓儀式方面咧，因為喺即係全國性法律裏邊咧，喺一個列出一系列咧係需要奏唱國歌嘅場合嘅，其中係有包括咧就係宣誓儀式嚇。咁所以當我哋去做一個本地立法嘅時候咧，我哋都要考慮就係喺全國性法律裏邊有嘅相關要求。我哋第一就應該係喺本地法例裏邊咧嚟去反映到啦。我哋都要考慮翻香港個實際嘅情況。咁所以喺宣誓儀式上邊，喺目前嚟講，喺行政長官主要官員、行政會議成員咧，佢哋就任嘅時候咧，嘅宣誓儀式咧，其實本身都係已經係有奏唱國歌嘅安排。咁所以同樣地，喺我哋呢啲嘅主要嘅一啲公職人員裏邊，包括咧我哋嘅司法人員同埋咧係立法會議員咧，如果係喺一個宣誓儀式一個咁莊嚴咁重要嘅場合裏邊咧，就係列明係一個奏唱國歌嘅場合咧，呢個其實咧都係好自然嘅事情。咁所以咧就我哋喺考慮咗之後咧，就喺個本地立法裏邊咧，喺附表咧，我哋都係建議咧係將立法會議員咧係宣誓儀式咧係作為一個係又係一個奏唱國歌嘅場合，係一個咁嘅考慮嘅。好啦，咁咧所以咧就係喺立法會議員嘅宣誓安排上邊，即係話換句話説，就係當議員喺宣誓之前嘅時候咧，咁就應該係會有一個係奏唱國歌嘅安排嚇。咁當然即係呢個會係一個宣誓儀式嘅一部分啦。咁你又至於話咁會唔會係構成即係會唔會係宣誓無效或者所謂即係 DQ 嗰啲問題咧？我諗咧就應該其實係睇緊兩方面嘅。第一咧就係話喺國歌法之下，如果係一個奏唱國歌嘅場合，咁你又係參與緊呢個奏唱國歌場合嘅當中嘅時候，咁當然就係如果有任何嘅行為係構成公開故意係侮辱國歌嘅話咧，咁呢個係有機會咧係喺國歌條例裏邊咧係觸犯到咧相關嗰個嘅即係罪行，同埋咧係有機會咧係負上刑責，呢個係第一個部分。第二個部分咧就係睇個宣誓是否有效。宣誓是否有效咧？係基本上咧喺我哋嘅宣誓及聲明條例裏邊咧都係清楚地法例上係有一個嘅要求啦，同埋咧就係喺基本法104嘅釋法裏邊咧，亦都就翻宣誓方面嗰個要求咧，亦都係比較明確嘅嚟去列明咗咧，係基本法104咧裏邊嗰個嘅內容啦。咁所以其實嗰個監誓人咧去判斷嗰個嘅宣誓是否有效咧，其實基本上都係按照翻就係現行嘅法例相關嘅要求嚟去判斷嚇。咁所以即係如果係一個即係後任嘅立法會議員，佢係冇任何嘅意圖去作出一啲係侮辱國歌嘅行為，或者冇任何一個意圖嚟去表達出佢係即係唔尊重嚇，即係因為國歌係國家嘅象徵同標誌啊嘛。咁所以呢個都係會喺成個宣誓嘅嗰個要求上邊咧都係會咁樣整體上去睇。所以簡單嚟講咧，就係你按照翻宣誓及聲明條例裏邊嘅要求。同埋咧，就係基本法104裏面就呢個宣誓方面嗰個嘅要求咧，亦都係有一個清晰嘅説法。嗰度咧係由翻監誓人咧嚟去決定嘅嚇。
白色衫嗰位，無線電視曾善倫，其實想問翻個侮辱行為罪行到，你頭先都有答到咧，其實點解要延長嗰個檢控時限？但可唔可以話到俾公眾聽咧？就譬如香港國歌咁樣，其實會唔會有一個追訴力喺度咧？定係其實即係香港國歌如果係犯刑事法，其實係咪要等個法例立法之後先會生效？喺立法之前，如果你做呢個相關行為，其實應該唔會犯法嘅。另外就係嗰個宣誓嘅問題，你剛才都講到，其實係由監誓人去判斷啦，按相關法例。但係其實譬如有啲立法會議員會擔心，你奏唱國歌期間，我行咗出去，咁會唔會係跌入一個
就叫做貶損國歌呢個咁嘅意圖裡面咧，有啲民主派立法會議員的確係有個咁嘅擔憂。你可唔可以解釋清楚？譬如點為之係貶損國歌？亦都希望即係俾監誓人一個指引，到時點為之係違反咗國歌法？
好啊。第一個問題咧就係喺個全國性嗰個法律裏邊咧，其中有一條條文我哋冇採納嘅咧，就係都係講關於話即係幾時生效嘅問題啦。因為在我哋嘅本地法例裏邊咧，所有都係即係條例通過咗之後咧，就係跟住就係生效嘅嚇。咁所以咧，我哋嘅條例本身咧就冇嗰個即係追溯力嘅嚇。呢個第一點。第二咧都係翻翻去個宣誓嗰個問題啦，即係話喺一個宣誓儀式裏邊咧係有奏唱國歌嘅安排。咁嗰個監誓人本身去判斷咧，究竟係是否係違反咗個宣誓嘅要求咧？咁係要睇翻嗰個實際上嗰個行為，同埋咧就嗰個嘅情況喎。因為你話譬如候任議員佢話我冇出席到嗰個嘅奏唱國歌嘅環節，咁佢點解冇出席到咧？你話如果佢之前佢講明咧，就係我係用唔出席呢個奏唱國歌嘅環節嚟去表達我某啲政治嘅想法或者理念嘅，咁個考慮又會好唔同嘅。咁但係我覺得咧，就如果我從一個即係比較正常啲、正當啲嘅思路去諗咧，就係話一個候任嘅立法會議員，佢去獲選成為香港特別行政區立法會嘅議員，佢履行立法會本身嗰個嘅職責，亦都係喺佢嘅參選嘅時候，亦都係明確地咧係擁護基本法同埋效忠香港特別行政區咧。咁而呢個香港特別行政區嘅立法會係，亦都係中國中華人民共和國嘅香港特別行政區立法會。咁所以喺一國兩制嘅情況之下咧，就喺一個宣誓儀式當中有奏唱國歌嘅環節，這個其實都係一個一啲都唔係一啲好奇怪咧，亦都係比較正常嘅一個情況啦。咁而去即係隆而重之地嚟去參與呢個宣誓儀式，其實都係好正常嘅。咁所以咧，照計就應該唔會有啲咩問題嘅。咁所以咧，就如果你話有啲咩嘅擔心嗰啲咧，我覺得最主要咧就係最後有任何嘅檢控或者係判斷或者各樣嘢嘅時候咧，其實我哋自己本身都係有現行嗰個法律嘅制度啦，同埋咧就亦都係有任何嘅咧，亦都喺個司法嘅層面上咧，亦都係有一個嘅即係判斷。咁所以咧，我覺得呢樣嘢本身我哋係有個機制去處理嘅。
黑色衫嗰位，
from standard. So, as you said from the document, violation under clause 7 may involve a large crowd of unidentified culprits. So, how will the government identify this culprit? For sometimes 2 years is not enough because from some videos, the faces of those people might be too blur. So, are you going to install many high resolution cameras so that you can identify all people who might boo the national anthem or around the football stadiums or race courses? So this is the first question. And the second, how do you define a publish? Because you said publish to the public the distorted anthem is also a crime. So if somebody just share with their friends, but not to publish onto the internet to all people, is this still a crime? And also about the disqualification of the legislators. If they don't want to identify or to acknowledge the central government, so as they don't like the Communist Party, and they walk out when the national anthem is played, so is this will this be identified as not upholding the basic law?
Okay, thank you. So altogether 3 questions. The first one about the extended period of prosecution. Basically, we want to ensure that the legislation could be effectively enforced. And so the present proposals basically strike a balance between effective enforcement and also keeping the prosecution period to a minimum. It's just that we can emphasize that there may be circumstances that there may involve a number of people in committing the offense. And to allow sufficient time for the police to investigate and also to institute the prosecution, probably we need more than 6 months. and that's why we come up with this proposals. So as regards the enforcement, I'm sure that A, we don't want to see any prosecution. We want people to respect the national anthem, and this offense provisions would never be used. But if there are such a circumstances, I'm sure that the enforcement agencies, the police, would, with the established practice and mechanisms, to collect evidence and to consider whether the evidence are sufficient or not, and then put to DOJ for considerations, and then the DOJ would consider to whether to prosecute or not, and then for the court to decide. So there are established systems to safeguard and to ensure that these offense provisions would be properly enforced. So that's the first question. The second one, as regards the definition of published, actually in the draft bill, there is a definition there. Published includes to communicate to the public in any form, including speaking, writing, printing, displaying notices, broadcasting, screening, and playing of tapes or other recorded material, and B, to distribute, disseminate, and make available to the public. So there is a definition there, and also publish include, distribution in the cyber world. So the distribution of materials through the internet and in the cyber worlds are also included. So the third question is about the about the oath taking, about the oath taking and also the validity of the oath. Well, basically, if you're talking about someone who want to walk out and to demonstrate that his disagreement or what with the Central People's Government, I think for anyone who want to be elected as a legislator, as part of the established systems, it's very clear that he or she should uphold the basic law and pledge allegiance to the Hong Kong Special Administrative Region, and his or her act should be consistent with what he or she has declared when he submitted the nomination. Thank you.
因為都有好多即係行家想問啦，我諗每一個人咧，即係舉手嘅時候咧，盡量即係問一條問題嚇。綠色衫嗰位。
局長你好 ，Now TV 專務客有問題想問翻，就係咧關於就係係咪一定要參與嗰個奏唱國歌嘅場合，佢哋先至會因為佢哋嘅行為可能而犯刑事法啦？即係譬如以往都可能試過喺立法會嘅公聽會，有啲人可能作出即係有講過話國歌好難聽嘅呢一啲評論，日後呢一啲嘅言論係咪都唔係違法行為咧？另外都想問翻二次創作嗰度咧，即係法例生效之後係咪唔可以對國歌作任何改編，即係譬如而家有啲流行曲，可能《琴日奇遇記》啊，或者《全日愛》呢啲生效之後，係咪唔可以再唱咧？唔該曬。好。
第一咧就係嗰個嘅頭先講到就係睇個參與出席一個奏唱國歌場合。其實嗰個問題咧就其實有兩個部分嘅。第一個部分咧就係話如果係喺一個奏唱國歌嘅場合，而你係出席同埋參與其中咧。咁咧就你應該咧係即係舉止莊重，應該肅立，唔應該有咧不尊重國歌嘅行為。咁呢個咧喺條例草案裏邊咧係其中嘅一個條款裏邊寫咗嘅。但係呢一個本身咧係一個指引性條文嚟嘅，呢個係一個指引性條文，亦即係話咧即係你應該係有尊重國歌嘅話咧，咁你應該係有一個咁嘅即係禮儀。咁但係呢個條文本身咧係不帶有罰則性嘅，咁所以呢個一方面。但係另一方面咧就係、是如果是去做了一些公開和故意去侮辱國歌的行為，而是有個意圖去侮辱國歌，那么呢就这个呢是會構成一個罪行。那么这個情況呢基本上在個條例草案裏面呢就會有三個方面寫了的。第一呢就是说你去篡改那個的國歌歌詞，或者是歌曲的曲譜，或者呢你是以歪曲同埋貶損嘅方式嚟去奏唱國歌，又或者你係咧係以任何嘅方式侮辱國歌。 咁所以咧就變咗唔單止話咧，你一定要係出席一個奏唱國歌嘅場合咧，你先至係會觸犯到咧係即係侮辱國歌行為，因為你可以有好多唔同嘅方式咧，達至你嗰個嘅意圖侮辱國歌嘅嘅行為出現，而又係公開同埋故意地嚟去表達嘅。咁所以咧呢個係你嗰個問題。第二咧就係就翻嗰個嘅即係二次創作嘅問題啦。咁其實咧就係好似頭先我所講啦，因為嗰個嘅條例裏邊亦都講明啦。就係、是、任何人如果係意圖侮辱國歌，而係故意即係篡改國歌嘅歌詞同埋曲譜咧，咁呢個咧係屬於犯罪嘅。換句話說咧，因為其實國歌如果係國家嘅象徵同埋標誌咧，亦都要去尊重咧。咁國歌本身嘅歌詞同埋曲譜咧，就唔應該去篡改佢嘅。咁所以如果你攞住首國歌，攞住首國歌嘅歌詞同埋曲譜，你嚟去篡改咧，咁呢個咧，就係即係好有機會咧，你係會觸犯到咧，就嗰個侮辱國歌嗰方面嗰個嘅即係罪行嘅。但係如果你係講緊一個嘅創作嚇，我自己本身做咗一個創作出嚟，喺呢個創作裏邊咧，可能有部分嘅環節嚇，就可能係會同呢個國歌嘅嗰個歌詞或者嗰個曲調咧係會相同啊或者相似。咁個問題就要睇整首嘅創作裏邊咧，究竟啲人睇咗落去之後咧，會唔會覺得嗰首係國歌？第二咧就係咧，啲人睇咗落去之後咧，會唔會覺得咧，呢一首嘅創作本身咧係達至一個咧係即係侮辱國歌嘅一個咁嘅即係情況，係咁樣嘅嚟去判斷嘅。咁所以頭先你所講嗰個，譬如話《球迷奇遇記》啊咁樣咧，咁第一咧就佢唔係攞住首國歌嚟去改啊。我見到嗰度都係整首係一首嘅曲啦，歌曲。咁就佢開頭嘅時候就有幾個音嘅嚇，咁所以咧就譬如咧《球迷奇遇記》嗰啲，我係睇唔到有啲即係咩嘅問題喺度。但係咧最重要嘅一點咧就係話國歌本身既然間係國家嘅象徵同埋標誌咧，就唔好攞首國歌本身攞佢啲詞同埋曲咧就嚟去改啦嚇，因為咁嘅時候咧就其實亦都係即係有機會咧係會就係造成咧係一個即係侮辱國歌嗰個情況。
紅色衫，
冷衫，係。係局長你好，明報記者梁志康。三方面問題咧，第一方面都係想問翻DQ 宣誓儀式嗰方面啦。其實即係宣誓儀式個角色，除咗監誓人之外，亦都有即係政府係唔係入禀 DQ 呢個角色啦。咁其實局長係咪唔排除將來如果有議員喺宣誓儀式嘅時候唔出席呢個唱國歌嘅環節，其實都可能會透過一啲宣誓及聲明條例之類嘅條例去入禀 DQ 個議員咧。咁第二方面就係即係有好多公眾都有個關注，就係點解政府唔就住更多嘅侮辱國歌嘅例子嚟舉例？即係點解唔可以令公眾清晰一啲？即係譬如話我就唱國歌嘅時候，我背對住個場合，究竟係咪侮辱啊？我唔開口唱係咪侮辱咧？咁同埋第三方面咧就係、
是、我諗暫時有兩條先。
好啊，喺嗰個宣誓要求上邊咧，其實就係喺即係我哋嘅宣誓及聲明條例啦，同埋咧就係基本法104嗰個嘅解釋，同埋咧就係有相關嘅法庭嗰個案件嘅判詞裏邊咧，其實咧都係好清楚確定咗咧，就係立法會議員喺就職嘅時候嘅宣誓咧係憲制性要求，並且咧係必須要喺形式同埋實質上咧係要符合法律嘅規定。咁呢個咧係包括咧宣誓嘅形式同埋誓詞嘅內容嚇，符合法例嘅要求啦，要真誠莊重咁宣誓啦，同埋喺宣誓嘅時候咧係真誠相信同埋嚴格遵守誓詞內嘅承諾，係嘛？咁所以呢個嘅嗰個嘅法定嘅要求咧，其實係喺我哋嘅本地法例，喺我哋法庭嘅判決裏邊嘅判詞，同埋喺基本法104嘅解釋裏邊咧，其實都係好清楚地係羅列咗出嚟嘅。第二咧就係喺如果你睇翻喺基本法104嘅解釋裏邊咧，其中佢嗰個説明裏邊咧，亦都有提到咧，就係話宣誓人如果係故意以行為、語言、服飾、道具等方式違反涉讀宣誓程序同埋儀式咧，就亦都應該認定咧該宣誓行為咧係不符合宣誓嘅形式或者實質要求，從而宣誓無效。咁所以咧就具體的情況咧，你唔可能咧而家咁講咧，就話如果你咁做咧，就係一定係得或者唔得，或者咁咧就會點樣嘅？因為咧，你每一個嘅情況咧，你都要睇當時咧究竟佢係講咗啲乜嘢，做咗啲乜嘢，或者喺之前佢講咗啲乜嘢，做咗啲乜嘢，或者佢之後佢講咗啲乜嘢，做咗啲乜嘢嚟去判定嘅。 咁所以但係咧就是、一個好清晰嘅咧，就係話無論喺我哋嘅本地法例，無論喺我哋嘅法庭嘅判詞裏邊，無論我哋喺基本法104嘅解釋裏邊咧，對於立法會議員就職嘅時候宣誓嗰、那個嘅要求咧係清晰嘅。咁所以無論係監誓人又好，或者無論係政府又好咧，都係按照翻呢個嘅即係宣誓嘅要求咧啊嚟去行事嘅。
最後邊白色恤衫嗰位。
Hi, Mr. I'm Caleb Loom from TVB News. I just want to ask how you distinguish between an insult and creations, for example, like the pop music that's similar to the national anthem. And would the police and government consider the factor of freedom of speech before making a prosecution? Thank you.
Oh, okay, thank you. Well, I think there are sayings that or concerns that the national anthem bill would limit freedom of expression and freedom of speech. And I think we need to make clear that the freedom of expression and freedom of speech are not without boundary. And actually, in a court case in 1999, the Court of Final Appeal has stated very clearly that imposing some reasonable restriction or limitation on the expressions and also on speech are justified. Provided, of course, it's a proportional. And that's the case concerning the National Flag Ordinance. And the point is that restrictions or the limitations are restricting the format of expressing your view, but not the content of what you want to express. That means that you are still entitled to your views and your expression, but not in this format or not in this form. So I think this concept is very clear, and especially it's confirmed by a Court of Final Appeal case back to 1999. And so what's your first question? Well, I think it's difficult to categorically say, for each creations, whether it's okay or not. But we need to back to the basic principles and the elements. That is, for any offense, in the offense provision, they state very clearly that you need to have a mens rea, you have to the necessary act, and you are publicly and intentionally and doing this insulting act. And so it's for the, I'm sure that the enforcement agencies and also the DOJ will consider very carefully all the available evidence to decide whether to proceed with a prosecution or not. And also the court would likewise would carefully consider all the available evidence and also the legal requirements to form a view. Thank you.
綠色衫嗰位，你好，信報嘅周依老有兩個問題嘅局長。頭先你提到話依條草案咧係即係全國性嘅法律啦，同埋係即係參照內地嘅國歌法。想問一下點解嗰個罰則咧似乎係仲嚴過內地嘅國歌法？因為內地淨係提到係要行政拘留啦，但係香港嗰個係要涉及監禁。另外就係嗰、那個因為香港依條係新引入嘅條例咧，會唔會話因為喺內地咧已經至少有兩宗同類嘅案例嘅，會唔會喺香港去演繹嗰、那個譬如侮辱啊、貶損嗰啲嘅條文嘅時候咧，係會參考內地現有嘅案例嚟到去做咧？唔該。
好啊，多謝。第一咧就係、是、透過本地立法去實施全國性嘅國歌法咧，呢、這個其實就係體現一國兩制嚇。呢、這個就正正係。一國兩制嗰個嘅精神咧，就是、一個全國性嘅法律嚇，唔係咧就即刻公布就喺香港實施，而係透過香港嘅本地法例咧，按照香港實際嘅情況，同埋因為我哋兩地嗰個嘅法律制度咧，亦都係唔同啦。咁所以咧就係、是、亦都係存在有咁嘅需要咧，我哋透過本地立法嚟去做。咁呢個係第一點啦。第二點咧就係、是、咧，所以同樣地咧，就喺我哋嗰個嘅條例裏邊咧所相關嗰啲嘅罰則咧。亦都會同內地咧係不盡相同，呢、這個亦都係好正常啊，因為大家嗰個體制係唔同啦。 第三咧就係咧喺內地嘅全國嘅全國性嘅國歌法裏邊咧，其實佢都唔係個罰則咧，唔係淨係得行政拘留嘅，只不過咧佢嗰個嘅即係坐監嗰個嘅刑罰咧，佢唔係喺佢個國歌法裏邊去寫嘅，佢另外有一個嘅即係刑罰啊，中華人民共和國嘅刑罰咧係一樣係有呢一個嘅即係嗰個嘅罰則嘅，咁佢哋嗰個罰則咧都係有一個監禁嘅即係刑罰嚟嘅嚇。咁所以咧就唔係淨係睇我哋全國性法律裏邊咧嗰個行政拘留，所以呢個咧肯定就係嗰、那個係一個誤解嚟嘅。
紅色衫嗰位，
係啊，香港電台林萬山，想問一問教育方面咧條例嗰度就寫提到啦將國歌法納入中小嘅教學啦，要發出指示。想問一問咧，即係嗰個指示係啲咩意思咧？係咪一定要奏唱咧？另外就話，即係中小嘅教學，中小學亦都包括咗特殊學校同埋國際學校。咁點解即係譬如國際學校外國嘅學生點解要學國歌咧？同埋特殊學校嘅學生，如果係即係譬如喺奏唱國歌嘅時候喺度笑啊玩啊，咁會唔會構成侮辱國歌嘅成分咧？另外就係公眾發佈嗰度咧，頭先局長都答咗少少，但係唔係咁。係啦，想問一問，即係發放嗰度咧，嗰度條例就寫明要向公眾發放啦。咁譬如朋友之間去傳送一啲嘅有關嘅嘢，會唔會即係都觸犯咗嗰個刑法咧？唔該。
好，第一個咧喺教育嗰度咧，嗰、那個條例裏邊講咧就係教育局局長會發出指示嚇。咁發出嘅指示咧，主要嚟講咧就係話中小學咧係需要教授呢、這個國歌。咁就讓學生係了解呢個國歌嘅歷史同埋精神啦，同埋咧就係即係學呢個唱國歌嘅。咁呢一個咧，其實因為喺教育系統裏邊咧，本身佢已經有個機制啦，同埋有亦都係有相關嗰啲法例咧，去喺學校裏邊佢哋嗰啲嘅課程啦、課程嘅指引啦，同埋咧佢哋點樣去即係引導同埋監督咧有關嗰啲嘅即係教學咧，咁啊全部有曬啲機制嘅。同埋佢亦都有一啲咧學與教嘅資源咧嚟去做嘅，咁所以基本上咧就係去履行翻呢個全國性法律呢個嘅要求，就係話喺中小學裏邊咧係需要教授國歌咧呢樣嘢咧，就係用翻我哋現行嘅教育機制嚟去執行。咁個涵蓋嘅範圍咧就應該基本上就係所有嗰啲學校啦，亦都包括國際學校啦。咁你話譬如有一啲嘅有特別需要嘅學校咁樣，咁呢個咧到你真正落實嘅時候咧，當然係要按實際嘅情況。嚟去，我相信佢哋本身有嗰個嘅專業嘅知識同埋專業嘅經驗咧，係點樣嘅嚟去教授嘅？咁你話譬如喺國際學校裏邊點解或者都係要學唱國歌或者係有嗰個嘅認識咧？咁我諗你喺任何一個地方咧，你都會認識嗰個地方嘅即係文化歷史，亦都會去尊重咧係嗰個地方。的國家的象徵和標誌，亦都會同樣地尊重其他地方的即係國歌嚇。咁所以我諗呢一個係亦都係一個好自然嘅、好容易理解的一件事情啦。咁另外咧就係喺嗰個即係發布方面咧，嗰、那個係講緊咧就係喺個定義裏邊都係講緊向公眾啊作出呢一個咁嘅發布，向公眾嚟去分發同埋傳播或者提供嘅。咁所以最主要睇下咧，就係話你嗰個行為本身咧，係咪向公眾嚟去發放呢樣嘢？咁所以如果你係將一樣嘢upload 咗上去個互聯網度或者睇 YouTube 度發放，咁我諗好明顯地呢個你係向公眾發放。主要你睇下呢個係咪向公眾發放啊？
最後兩條問題。深色衫依位女士。
唔該，局長。南華早報 Kimi 嘅，想追問翻啲情景嘅問題，即係之前一路都即係少答嘅，即係其實都正多好多都關注，就係話嗰個侮辱啊、貶損嗰個定義就即係比較模糊咁。其實以往都有政黨就譬如去個金紫荊，即係喺播國歌嘅時候就背對即係。背向個會場，然後就雙手交叉，可唔可以都講多少少啲情景之下，係咪都係觸犯到侮辱國歌咧？算唔算係有意圖去侮辱？係咪入到罪咧？ 咁第二都想追問翻就係嗰個少少學校嗰個指示咧，可唔可以解釋多少少教育局嗰個係咪都有一個法律效力？即係如果係一啲國際學校係跟唔到嘅，即係冇做到去令到學生學習唱國歌嘅時候有冇罰則喺度咧？唔該你。
好啊。第一就講學校嗰度先啦。學校嗰度咧就教育局局長發出指示嗰個咧，基本上就係個意思就係話佢用翻現有嗰個機制嚟去做。咁當然就喺個教育系統裏邊咧，佢哋會有一啲係會係即係一啲必須要做啦，有啲可能係指引啦，有啲係會俾一啲資源你去支援啦，學與教嘅資源等等各樣嘢。咁你話同翻啲學校嗰啲咧，採取嗰個方式咧，一定唔會話咧就話你我點樣去罰你嘅，即係呢個亦都唔應該係一個咁嘅態度。喺而事實上，教育局亦都同咗中小學，亦都包括國際學校嗰度咧，亦都已經係進行咗嗰個嘅討論啊。咁亦都佢哋其實基本上對呢樣嘢本身係冇問題嘅。大家都覺得咁，你要去教授呢、這個學生去認識啊國歌嘅歷史精神同埋教唱國歌，這個、呢個咧唔存在有啲咩嘅問題。第二咧就係、是、咧，你同我講個情景嗰度咧，我都希望大家明白咧。即係我係唔可能咧，一一對於每一個情景咧，就去話咧呢個咧就係即係中定唔中，呢個就係侮辱定係侮辱，呢個係有罰則定冇罰則。咁嘅時候，即係我做咗法庭㗎啦。咁呢個係冇可能嘅。同埋事實上咧，亦都係每一個情景咧，亦都唔可能單係咁樣講一句咧，就話呢個情景個結果應係點樣。因為你好多時咧，你都要睇嗰個嘅即係事情嘅發生，嗰個嘅言行舉止之前之後整體環境各樣嘢好多嘅原因嘅。咁所以咧，就我哋必須要去找住咧，就係嗰個嘅背後嗰個精神同埋個重點係啲乜嘢？成個國歌法裏邊條例草案嘅精神咧係兩樣嘢嘅。第一就係希望能夠咧透過呢個條例本身咧，能夠可以去推廣一個咧係尊重國歌。咁呢樣嘢本身其實就好自然嘅，但係咧都希望個社會上咧能夠可以尊重國歌，因為國歌咧係國家嘅象徵同埋標誌，呢個係第一點。第二點咧就係咧，如果係對於有一啲人咧，他們是要即是立心，他們是要有意圖公開和故意要去侮辱國歌的話，那不可能是完全沒有代價的，應該是要有刑責的，要有阻嚇作用的。所以為什麼才在條例裡面對於這些罪行本身是會有個罰則，而你看回條例草案裡面就這些罪行那個的門檻其實都是很一點都不低的，那個門檻是你是有意圖侮辱國歌，你是公開和故意地做出侮辱國歌的行為，那你才會構成那個罪行。同時間也是要經過提出個檢控，透過法庭的裁決才能夠可以去定罪。我們其實要再回去看，就是說如果有人要去問我這樣做這樣做是否會構成侮辱國歌呢，我要反問他其實全心是想著想侮辱國歌呢，是吧？所以最正當的就是，即如果那個是一個奏唱國歌的場合，那就希望大家去尊重國歌，就不要做出一些是侮辱國歌的行為。這個是跟他的言論和即表達自由呢，這個不 是,是說一個的即無理的限制。言論和表達自由呢不是沒有界線的，在1999年的終審法院的一個有關國旗條例裏面的一個案件裏面，終審法院都是清晰地去講到，如果我們是對於一些言論的表達，一些的言論自由或者表達自由是施加的限制，這個是可以的，一個合理的限制是可以的，是放在國旗這個條例裏面是所謂的 justify 的，因為原因是國旗在現在這個情況就是國歌是國家的象徵和標誌，是應該要去尊重的，咁故所以咧，佢限制咗你表達嘅方式，即係話你唔可以透過一個侮辱國歌、侮辱國旗嘅方式嚟去表達你嘅意見。咁呢一個咁嘅限制同要求咧係合理嘅，但我冇限制到你其他你嗰啲嘅本身嗰個政見，你可以透過其他方式嚟去表達。不過你唔好搞國歌，你唔好作出一啲侮辱國歌嘅行為，其實就是一件咁嘅事。所以咧就本身我都一開始嘅時候我都講咧，就係、絕大部分嘅市民咧，我相信本身都係尊重國歌， 咁所以咧就係誒喺呢條條例草案裏邊咧，其實我哋嗰啲指引性條文咧，都係希望能夠可以即係誒引導到就係嗰個尊重國歌啦。咁所以咧，對於市民嘅日常生活咧係唔會有影響嘅嚇。咁誒另外一樣咧，頭先所講到咧就係話誒嗰個嘅誒即係定義嘅問題啦。譬如喺咩叫做侮辱咧，喺個條例草案裏邊咧係有定義嘅。侮辱就國歌而言咧，就係損害國歌作為中華人民共和國嘅象徵同埋標誌嘅尊嚴。咁我相信咧就即係有呢個咁嘅即係寫法咧我相信喺我哋嘅普通法制度之下咧我哋嘅法庭咧係有能力咧嚟去處理咧有關呢啲嘅案件。
OK， 最後一題嗰位深色衫嘅男士戴眼鏡位，
眾新聞記者局長你好，啱先都話唔能夠即係單靠即係一個情景就話。就係咪侮辱啦？但係始終內地都發生過，即係有網民就直播嗰陣時就咁唱咗頭一句嘅國歌，就俾人行政拘留咗5日。點樣確保即係市民喺公眾場合唔會即係有一個清晰嘅界定，係佢唔會就咁唱一句或者點樣嘅一個形式就誤墮法網咧？另外就係局長啱先都話延長嗰個檢控時間，其實唔係一啲新鮮嘅嘢咧，究竟係有啲？另外有啲咩法例係都試過啲咁樣嘅做法咧？
好第一個問題咧就係話你講到譬如內地有一啲嘅案件或者案例嗰啲咧，首先第一樣嘢咧就係咧喺香港是否觸犯嗰個嘅即係侮辱國歌呢一個嘅罪行咧，係跟翻香港嘅國歌條例草案或者將來通過咗嘅就係國歌條例。嚟去做，咁所以是否構成嗰個嘅罪行咧，就要睇翻我哋嗰個嘅本地法例嘅條文裏邊咧，對於呢個罪行要求咧嗰個嘅即係有啲乜嘢嘅即係因素元素嚟去講，係按翻嗰樣嘢嚟去做。咁所以我哋嗰個嘅執法同埋我哋嗰個司法嘅系統咧嘅處理咧，亦都係跟翻香港嘅制度嚟去做。咁我諗呢個亦都係同樣地咧，就喺一國兩制之下咧。我哋嘅本地立法方式去施行實施全國性嘅國歌法條例咧，都係就係咁樣嘅嚟去彰顯一國兩制嘅精神嘅。咁所以簡單嚟講咧，就係話有任何如果係即係侮辱國歌嘅行為，是否構成罪行咧？呢係按照將來通過咗嘅國歌條例嘅要求咧嚟去考慮嘅。咁頭先我都所講咧，成條例裏邊就其實好清晰嘅，有刑罰嘅條款咧係得兩條嘅啫。第一條咧就係不當地使用國歌，即係話喺嗰啲商業廣告、商標、私人喪事活動同埋咧就係公眾場所嘅背景音樂啲係唔應該使用國歌嘅情況。如果你使用咗咧，咁就有罰則，個罰則係罰款嘅，呢個冇坐監嘅。另一個咧就係你公開故意作出侮辱國歌嘅行為咧，咁呢一個咧就係需要刑責嘅。咁就係按照呢一個嘅條例裡面寫嘅情況嚟去判斷咯。咁所以咧就唔需要話咧就係內地嘅情況係咁就香港就係咁嚇，即係我哋而家講緊就係本地立法啊嘛，我講緊本地嗰個法例嘅要求啊嘛。咁啊，第二咧就係話嗰個嘅檢控咧超過一般嗰6個月或者延長個檢控期咧，喺其他條例裏邊咧都有嘅嚇。其實其中咧包括譬如喺旅館業條例啦、能源效益條例啦同埋私隱條例都有嘅。
好，唔該曬大家，多謝曬。
唔該曬。我哋就1月23日啦，就立法會首讀啦。咁啊，之後立法會會成立呢個法案委員會嘅。咁就立法會成立咗法案委員會之後咧，我哋當然全力配合佢哋嘅工作啦。咁審議嘅速度係點樣咧？當然要睇立法會法案委員會嗰個嘅進度啦。所以呢個咧就不在我控制之內嘅。但係咧，當然我哋個目標都希望咧就係國歌法咧嘅本地立法咧能夠可以早日完成。咁而事實上咧，呢個全國性法律咧，都係喺2017年嘅11月咧，就已經係實施啊嘛。咁所以呢個都係我哋嘅目標，就係希望能夠可以咧盡早完成嗰個審議，能夠三讀通過嚇。
好，唔該曬。
我哋會繼續努力不懈咁樣去解釋，即係裏邊嗰個內容同埋嗰個情況嚇。因為如果係一位立法會議員，佢係宣誓認真地去履行佢立法會議員即係職責嘅話咧，照計就喺一個宣誓嘅過程裏邊， 同埋喺一個有一個奏唱國歌嘅環節咧，照計就冇乜理由會構成一個問題同埋擔心嘅。